Good morning, dear children. Most of the natural substances are not chemically pure. They exist as mixtures. We have learned two types of mixtures, homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. In order to separate the individual components of a mixture, different methods should be used. Some heterogeneous mixtures can be separated by using physical methods like hand picking, sieving, filtration, etc. But sometimes some special technique have to be used for the separation of the components of a mixture. Today we are going to learn those methods for separating the components of a mixture. Different methods for separating the components of a mixture are, first one, evaporation. Evaporation method is used to separate non-volatile component from a volatile component. For example, to separate dye from ink. You know that ink is a mixture of dye and water. So in order to separate the dye from water, we can use this evaporation method. Second method is centrifugation. Centrifugation method is used to separate colloidal particles. You know that colloidal particles are so small, so they can easily pass through filter paper. Then we can use this method, centrifugation, to separate colloidal particles. Third method is sublimation. Sublimation is very familiar to you. Sublimation is the process by which solids are directly changing into gas without going into liquid state. That is sublimation. So sublimation method is used to separate sublimable volatile component from non-sublimable non-volatile component. For example, to separate ammonium chloride or camphor or naphthalene, all these are sublimable substances. To separate those sublimable substances from non-sublimable substances like common salt, we can use this sublimation method. Okay, then fourth method is separation using separating funnel. This technique is used to separate two immiscible liquids. For example, to separate oil and water or petrol and water, etc. Fifth method is chromatography. Chromatography is used to separate colored components. For example, to separate dye from ink, we can use this chromatography technique. Sixth method is distillation and seventh method is fractional distillation. Both distillation and fractional distillation methods are used to separate miscible liquids. This fourth one, separation using separating funnel, is used to separate immiscible liquids. Immiscible liquids means liquids that cannot be mixed with. But this distillation and fractional distillation methods are used to separate miscible liquids. The difference between this distillation and fractional distillation is, distillation method is used to separate two miscible liquids having sufficient difference in their boiling point. For example, suppose the boiling point of a liquid A is 20 Kelvin and another liquid B is 100 Kelvin, then we can use this distillation method if both the liquids are miscible liquids. But fractional distillation method is used to separate two miscible liquids having boiling point difference less than 25 Kelvin. For example, if the boiling point of a liquid A is 20 Kelvin and another liquid B is 30 Kelvin, then the boiling point difference is only 10 Kelvin. Then we can use this fractional distillation method. Last method is crystallization. Crystallization technique is used to obtain pure substance from impure some. For example, pure copper sulfate can be obtained from impure copper sulfate through crystallization technique. So all these are the methods to separate the components of a mixture. Let us learn each method in detail. Separating the components of a mixture. The first method is evaporation. This method is generally used to separate non-volatile component from volatile component, where volatile component easily evaporate, leaving behind the non-volatile component in the mixture. For example, ink is made of dye and water. Dye being non-volatile gets separated from water during the process of evaporation. Let us now have a look on activity. Second method is centrifugation. Sometimes in solid liquid mixtures, solid particles are so small that they easily pass through filter paper, thereby makes their separation impossible. In such cases, technique of centrifugation is used. In this technique, a solid liquid mixture is allowed to spin in centrifuging machine. During this spin, force act in inward direction, due to which heavy particles settle at bottom while lighter particles remain at top. Let us see the applications of centrifugation. It is used in diagnostic laboratories for blood and urine test. It is used in dairies and home to separate butter from cream. Another use is it is used in washing machine to squeeze out water from wet clothes. Let us now have a look on activity. Third method is separation using separating funnel. This technique is mainly used to separate two immiscible liquids. That means mixtures that cannot be mixed well. Example, oil and water. This mixture is poured in separating funnel and is allowed to stand undisturbed for some time, so that separate layers of immiscible liquids are formed, which can be easily separated by opening the stopcock. When the lower layer is completely poured out, then close the stopcock so that upper layer remains in the separating funnel.
Then applications. It is used to separate mixture of oil and water, and also used to separate iron from its ore. Let us now have a look on activity. Next separation technique is sublimation. This method is used to separate mixture that contain a sublimable volatile component, for example ammonium chloride, from a non sublimable impurity, example common salt. Next method is chromatography. In this method, a spot of sample mixture, for example ink, is applied on filter paper, and then filter paper is placed in solvent water. Component in mixture which are more soluble in solvent rises faster on filter paper, thereby separating all components from sample. Application. This method is used to separate colors in a dye and is used to separate pigments from natural color. Let us now have a look on activity. Another method is distillation. This process is used to separate two miscible liquids having sufficient boiling point difference. In mixtures, liquid with lower boiling point evaporates first and undergoes condensation and is collected in a container. Liquid with high boiling point evaporate later. Hence, it becomes easy to separate both liquids. Example, mixture of acetone and water. Let us now have a look on activity. Next method is fractional distillation. This method is used to separate two miscible liquids having boiling point difference less than 25 Kelvin. The apparatus is similar to simple distillation apparatus. The only difference is fractional column is connected in between distillation flask and condenser. Due to low difference in boiling point, both liquids evaporate simultaneously and face obstruction in fractional column. Due to obstructions, liquid with high boiling point condenses down in the flask, and liquid with low boiling point reaches the condenser and is then collected in container. Hence liquids get separated. how can we separate different components of air? You know that air is a mixture of several gases, and these gases can be separated by fractional distillation technique. This is brought about by compressing and cooling of air and allowing it to slowly warm up in a fractionating column. Air is first passed through a filter to remove impurities like dust particles. Filtered air is then passed through compressor and is compressed to very high pressure around 200 atmosphere. Compressed air is passed through a freezing unit where it is cooled to about minus 200 degrees Celsius. The cool and compressed air passes through a separator, but carbon dioxide gas solidifies and is separated as dry ice. The air which is now free from carbon dioxide is passed through an expansion jet where it liquefies. This liquid air is allowed to slowly warm up in a fractionating column. Nitrogen first boils at minus 196 degrees Celsius and is separated. The argon, which boils at minus 186 degrees Celsius, is then collected. Oxygen, which has high boiling point, is left behind and is collected separately. Next method is crystallization. What is crystallization? The process of obtaining crystals of a soluble substance from its hot saturated solution is called crystallization. Crystallization is only a physical change because no new substances are formed during the process. It involves only a change in physical state. Crystallization is used to obtain pure substance from naturally occurring impure substances. Here is an experiment to see how crystallization occurs. Take 100 ml of water in a beaker and heat it on a Bunsen burner. When water begins to boil, add about 2 ml of dilute sulfuric acid and then a spoonful of copper sulfate. Stir the content with a glass rod. Stir it continuously and add more impure copper sulfate until no more of it dissolves. Fasten a thread in the middle of a wooden stick and suspend in a glass. Stop heating and pour the saturated copper sulfate solution in a glass. Place the glass aside and cover the beaker with a cardboard. cool the solution. Leave the setup for 24 hours. After 24 hours, you will find blue crystals of pure copper sulfate at the base of the beaker. Remove the crystal from the glass and dry it in warm air.